Hi there, I am Dokus and today we'll get you started with your ATOS Q. In this tutorial, I'll share some tips and tricks with you which might help you to scan parts even faster than we did up till now. Feel free to pause at any point to follow along. There are also chapter segments if you wish to skip ahead. Let's get started. Until now, we always used all the automatic features from the software, which means automatic exposure times and automatic cutout. This is, however, not necessary. We can play along with it as we want. The automatic exposure time is measured with the small spots. You notice that when I rotate the part, the small spots appear, and this is actually the sensor who is measuring the optimal exposure time in the center of the measuring volume. If I want to play around with that, I can click on the small icon above the live camera view. This will pop up a small circle. I can choose now where to put the circle and make it bigger or smaller. This is now the new zone where the automatic exposure time will be measured. So if I take a scan now, instead of measuring in the middle, I am measuring at the spot that I pointed to. This makes it very easy to measure parts with different colors, or for example, a part with a hole in the middle, where I don't need to measure the actual exposure times. The second thing I would like to point out is that we can scan even faster than we are doing now. Suppose that I want to measure this part, but I'm not very interested in all the tiny details, then I can change the measurement mode. I can do this by clicking on the small arrows here. Here you have the option fast scan or full resolution. This actually means that the sensor will take less pixels, but is able to scan much, much faster. You can see that the time necessary to take a scan is way shorter now. So I can easily rotate the part and take the next scans much, much faster than I did before. The last thing I would like to show you is the cutout of the points. The software automatically detects the table and the background and cuts it out. But we can also do that ourselves. You can find this option here. It's called Cutout Points. When I open that, you can see that the automatic cutout is still active. I can change that to manual and everything will get recalculated. I now have the possibility to choose my own plane which I want to cut out. Or I can use the tools below to manually select data that I don't want. For example, if I choose Select True Surface, I can just select data which is not of interest. Make sure it's selected in 3D view and press Ctrl Delete to delete the data. These were the tips and tricks that might help you to manipulate your data easier and to make scans faster. If you experience anything different from what you have seen here, or if you have any issues with your ATOS Q, please reach out to us via support@handsonmetrology.com. For more getting started information, please check out our other tutorial videos. Thank you for watching and we'll see you next time.